On Medical Watch tonight, spotting the early signs of ALS in speech.
Medical reporter Dina Baer has more on why researchers are tuning in for clues.
Back in 2014, millions of people poured icy water over their heads to spread ALS awareness and support research for the devastating neurodegenerative disease. Now tech developers want to hear your voices.
On average, they only give you 2 to 5 years of life after your diagnosis. And there's some people who progress very quickly.
That hasn't been the case for Brian Andre.
I'm really in a very small percentage of patients who see little or no progression.
He's been living with ALS for 6 years.
My weakness is in my left side, left leg and arm. So it throws my gait off. I can't actually be in clinical trials because almost all clinical trials rule you out as a subject if you've had the disease for 2 years.
Please say peep.
Peep.
But he can lend his voice once a week. The 64-year-old clicks through a series of vocal exercises.
Pataka, 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 pataka.
And answers questions about his fine and gross motor skills.
Can you swallow pills? Pretty important if you have to take medications. I've got no problem doing that.
His voice strength, facial movements, and breathing, functions often weakened during the course of the disease, are all recorded, then evaluated through an algorithm in development by Everything ALS, an organization devoted to bridging technology with patient care and research.
The speech is a very early indicator in a lot of diseases. The machine learning and artificial intelligence is actually telling us there is a change in certain metrics.
Please say, the vase is very thin and fragile.
The vase is very thin and fragile.
For tech entrepreneur and Everything ALS founder Indu Navar, the project is deeply personal.
Unfortunately, I lost my dear husband to this disease.
It took Peter Cohen 2.5 years to get a diagnosis, even though he and his wife sought the advice of doctors at the first signs of trouble.
Even though we went very early, they said, you're so early, come back after 8 months, we'll see how much you've degraded, right? That just did not sit well with me. So
ultimately, Indu hopes the algorithm and voice data will not only help doctors determine if a drug therapy is working, but she also hopes it will serve as a tool to diagnose patients much faster.
Think of it as like we're finding neurology today at stage 4 cancer. We're diagnosing ALS, more like 60 to 80% of the motor neurons are dead. So that means, you know, we need to be catching it when less than 10% is dead. I work with my heart because I've never had so much purpose in my life.
Brian's wife, Lori, feels the same way.
Every day you wake up and you're like, I hope there's no progression. I hope nothing changes.
That is it. That's a session.
If not for Brian, obviously for the next generations, it's super important that we continue to move the ball forward. Anything we throw at this disease, the better.
The citizen-driven research project is not just for ALS patients. Otherwise, healthy people can lend their voices to the cause as controls for the study. Everything ALS plans to ultimately share their findings with thousands of researchers around the world in an effort to advance the science faster. If you'd like to learn more about the study, we have a link on our website. Back to you.